Period.
International Diamond Center. Locally owned, internationally connected.
We want them to take care of you, protect you, and make it the best experience that you could possibly have.
International Diamond Center, US 1 and PSL Boulevard, and always at shopidc.com.
Explore the wild at Palm Beach Zoo and Conservation Society, where every visit saves wildlife. Enjoy a leisurely stroll along our lush tropical pathways and experience unforgettable encounters with hundreds of animals from around the world. Feed colorful lorikeets, cool off at our splash pad, or go behind the scenes in an exclusive animal experience. From majestic big cats to lively pink flamingos, there's something for everyone. Purchase your tickets at palmbeachzoo.org. That's palmbeachzoo.org.
Hi, I'm Wendy Sartori-Link, your Palm Beach County Supervisor of Elections. The presidential preference primary and municipal elections are coming up on March 19th, with only the Republican Party holding a primary this election and some voters participating in their municipal elections. Eligible voters can vote in one of three ways: by mail, at any early voting location from March 9th through March 17th, or on Election Day from 7 a.m. to 7 p.m. Visit votepalmbeach.gov to view your status and learn more. We'll see you at the polls.
Hey, it's Tina from Josh Cohen and the Home Team. Celsius is my go-to for all the good vibes. Whether I'm at the beach, hitting the gym, or hanging out with friends, Celsius keeps me refreshed and energized. Packed with 7 essential vitamins, it's the perfect drink for my active lifestyle. Try exciting new flavors like Cosmic Vibe or Lemon Lime. There's even on-the-go powder sticks so you can bring the good vibes with you wherever you go. Purchase your favorite flavor at your local retailer today. Celsius, essential energy drinks.
Calling all sports fans, grab your MVP card and head to Duffy's where you can catch all of the action. Not an MVP? Sign up for free and start earning rewards today. Duffy's is voted the best sports grill year after year with their award-winning burgers and wings. Don't forget about Duffy's famous 2-for-1 drinks all day, every day. And with over 80 TVs in every location, you'll never miss a minute of the game. Visit Duffy'sMVP.com to learn more. Duffy's, our game is always on.
Banyan Printing, your trusted printing, mailing, and signage partner in the Palm Beaches for over 45 years. Banyan Printing's new metallic ink press adds that extra shine so that your product comes out in glossy gold, sparkling silver, or any other color you want to shine. Banyan Printing is the official printer of Kaiser Athletics and would love to be your official printing partner as well. Order products and learn more about what Banyan Printing can do for your business at banyanonline.com or call 561-586-6220.
It's the 4 o'clock hour on ESPN 106.3. Fueled by Celsius, essential energy drinks. This is Josh Cohen and the Home Team, streaming live worldwide on YouTube on ESPN West Palm Play. Presented by Hard Rock Bet, Florida's official sports book. This is ESPN 106.3.
It is JC and the Home Team for the ride home. You are immersed in the experience. You can consume this show live on ESPN 106.3. You can consume it live on the ESPN app. You can also consume it by telling any smart speaker, you know, connected device, your Alexa, your Google Dot, your whatever, who cares? Tell it, play ESPN West Palm. Play ESPN West Palm. We stream live. Also, wherever you get your podcasts, please subscribe to the podcast. It is free, won't take up any memory, but it will allow for you to have the daily show broken up into hours 1 and 2, commercial breaks cut out, with you automatically. Listen when you want, where you want, how you want. Pause, rewind. You can pause, rewind it, and hear the moment that C-Cat realized that he wasn't supposed to yell out Robert Kennedy Sr.
He did it.
Again and again, backwards 10 seconds, backwards 10 seconds. Keep on listening.
You can play it over and over again. Just do that for us. And remember, we're also now live on YouTube on our ESPN West Palm Play YouTube channel, which is obviously free, but now we're also a video show, so you can watch us right there and see the looks of disappointment on my face as the show progresses.
Does he know who Robert Downey Jr.'s dad is?
Is it Ken Griffey Sr.?
No.
It's not. Damn it. F1 Miami. Tickets are available now to the 2024 Formula One Crypto.com Miami Grand Prix, May 3rd through the 5th. It's a 3-day event filled with art, music, world-class cuisine, and of course, 3 days of the world's best racing. It's also the first sprint race in the Americas for the year. Come watch the greats like Max Verstappen, Lewis Hamilton's last year with Mercedes before he flips over to Ferrari. There's a variety of seating and ticketing options, including grandstands with fantastic track views that put you literally in the center of the action. General admission passes available now from just $150. Join us for the 2024 Formula1Crypto.com Miami Grand Prix, May 3rd through the 5th. And remember, the Formula1Crypto.com Miami Grand Prix is a one-of-a-kind event that showcases the sport of not just F1 racing, but Miami's unique position as a global curator of culture. Tickets at F1 Miami GP. That's the letter F, the numeral 1, Miami GP is in GrandPrix.com. She is rocking an Astros hat that is a unique color scheme that looks as though it was designed by Travis Scott.
Absolutely.
Was it?
Going all in. I don't know.
But it looks like it was.
It's a whole vibe. They went off on the gear during spring training.
She is the first lady. She is the queen of the Delusional Republic. I know you're thinking, isn't she Dominican? Yes, but the Delusional Republic is a far, far away land where they believe far, far away things.
It's the best of both worlds.
Just like
of all the worlds.
Just like Van Halen saying. And he's back from surprising, almost ruining his mother's birthday surprise trip. To Charleston, South Carolina, C-Cat, Christian Cat. We missed you the last several days, man.
You did?
It's not the same without you.
Oh.
It's not.
It's good to hear.
Yeah. It's good to have you back. It's good. It's also an enormous indictment on Stone Lebanowitz. So
really?
I know he's listening right now.
Oh,
but,
no.
But no, I'll be with Stone solo on Friday, as a matter of fact. Me and Stoney doing things this coming Friday. Meanwhile, NFL free agency gone wild. Some of these moves you could see coming. I don't think what you could see was the abundance of in-division movement by teams that didn't mind losing a guy and having him sign in-division against a rival. Which one caught you the most off guard, C-Cat?
Well, I'm a Baltimore Ravens fan, so seeing a guy I saw on purple last year that was drafted to the Ravens. Patrick Queen, Pro Bowl linebacker. He was supposed to kind of lead that charge. Fill that gap as the vocal leader on the defense. It didn't quite happen because they trade for Roquan Smith, another vocal linebacker who led that team. He's now a Pittsburgh Steeler.
The hated rival.
Yeah.
In division, there are rivalries, obviously, but then there's that super rivalry.
Yeah.
So in the NFC East, you know, that's our hated rival. But nobody really hates Washington that much.
Right.
Because it's like, been good a long time.
They're cute.
Dallas, you kind of get in the way, but your fans are annoying. But in the AFC North, there's really just two factions of hatred. There's the Ohio teams. They have their thing. Let's not forget Sam Weiss, who said, "Stop throwing stuff on the field. You don't live in Cleveland."
It was one of my favorite pieces of audio ever.
Of ever.
And everybody loses it.
Yep. And then in Baltimore, it's Pittsburgh. In Pittsburgh, it's Baltimore. And you'd think it'd be Baltimore and Cleveland because Baltimore used to be Cleveland. You'd think that they would do more on that. But Baltimore's like, no, we don't care. Since we came here in 1996, you guys have been to zero conference championship games, and we've won two different Super Bowls.
I mean, it's just the same brand of football, too, with both cities. Like, just pound your face in, hard knock.
I'll pound your face in. How about that?
That said, they're both attitude of both sides, and there can only be one.
Saquon Barkley from the Giants to the Eagles. Pro Bowl Ravens linebacker Patrick Queen then goes to the Steelers. Green Bay running back Aaron Jones, who, by the way, they gave up on.
Mm-hmm.
It's not a case of like, hey, man, we can't get you paid. They thought we got a better option, so they signed and brought in.
Forget his name. What was his name? Who's on the Packers?
you prepared this entire show today, right?
Yeah.
Okay. The Miami Dolphins. I'm sorry. I'm at a loss there because it seems like recently when I go to you for those things, it's like I shouldn't go to you, and that's on me. That's my bad. Because a trial lawyer knows you never ask a question you don't already know the answer to, and I should never ask you something that I'm not sure that you know the answer to. Anyways.
Josh Jacobs.
Correct.
There we go.
Who, by the way, last season had the worst season of his career.
Right.
2022, fantastic. Last year, awful. By the way, everybody's still coming in at that $8 million mark. 2-16, 3-24. Running backs learn you can bet on yourself all you want. But it doesn't matter if the market is high supply, low demand. So let's go to now Jordan Poyer, who is a Pro Bowl cornerback of the Buffalo Bills, who now joins the Miami Dolphins. Is he an upgrade? Not necessarily. Is he a player that makes plays? Yes. He drops a lot of balls for me. There are key moments in games in which you grab that, and that's either six the other way or that drive ends. Jordan Poyer, I know what you play. They say you play defensive back because you can't catch, but I need him to make some more of those plays. So I'm going to ask the question here that we should ask, and that is, who has the most ability to hurt their former team more? Is it Patrick Queen going to Pittsburgh, harm he can do to his Ravens, formerly, or is it Saquon Barkley going to the Philadelphia Eagles and doing more harm to his former team, the Giants? Jeanette, you go first.
I go with Saquon Barkley going to the Philadelphia Eagles. Saquon Barkley became a staple in the Giants organization.
Right.
And that franchise and what Barkley, Saquon Barkley meant a lot to the Giants. Now I feel like going back to what you were saying, the best revenge is massive success.
Mm-hmm.
I think Barkley finding his success with the Eagles, an actual contending team, is going to be like the proverbial words to Giants fans and that organization overall. Look what you missed out. You've had this.
See, Kat, same question.
Yeah, hurting feelings. The Saquon move hurt more feelings than the Patrick Queen move, in my opinion. But I think just when we talk about on the field, the Giants aren't winning those games anyway. The Giants went from a 5-win team to a 3-win team, right, with that move. But you have the Steelers contending with the Ravens each and every year, depending on how talented each sides are. It doesn't matter. So always close games.
So this argument I think I gave to you in pre-show meeting, and I can't use it because you just said it for me. No, but the reality is I'm going to disagree with Jeanette. I'm going to agree with CCAP based on the fact that if the conversation is who hurts their former team more, there's two aspects. You not being here, how does it hurt us? You being there, how can that team now hurt us on top of that? Right? There are two sides to that.
Mm-hmm.
If you're not here, how much worse off are we? But then also, if you're there and we got you twice a year, how can you help them? That makes it even harder for us. So with that said, the answer is Patrick Queen, because the Steelers are a lot closer to winning the division, I think, than the Giants are. And the Steelers are a lot closer to being a playoff team contender than the Giants are. How much can you hurt a team that sucks anyway? How much can you hurt if they're not going to do anything? And then you going in, it only makes it worse, but it doesn't matter because you're out of contention. Does that make sense?
Yes, but I don't agree with that because I think Saquon Barkley purposely stayed with the Giants out of a form of loyalty and love for the organization. But at the end of the day, I feel like it was wasted talent on his. He probably feels that way.
Well,
now he's going to go to the Eagles, and he's going to be like, look at what I'm able to show off
year?
And do.
He did a one
he
year.
He did 1 year.
Last year, right? And it was because he had been tagged?
Yeah.
So, I mean, that is what that is. Coming up, when we return, a legendary coach roasts a conference rival on the air intentionally. Some of the laughter is awkward. Some of the laughter literally is saying, because it was like, yo, you're a legend, a legendary coach, and now you are going in on roasting a conference rival, knowing that you're doing it intentionally into your live microphone. You'll hear who and what they said coming up next. Right now, though, Hard Rock Bet. Florida's only legal sports betting app. Hard Rock Bet is legal in Florida. Hard Rock Bet, we are in the midst now of the month of March betness. Hard Rock betness. We got special stuff coming up for that big tournament thing that you know about. Stay locked in on that. But this time of year, everybody fills out a bracket, and that's great and all. You got to wait till you find out 3 days in that your bracket is broken. How about just playing the games? How about putting together parlays? How about live wagering because you're watching a game and you know the comeback is going to happen? You can sense that the upset's about to happen. You can do all of that on Hard Rock Bet, Florida's only legal sports book, the only place you can legally bet on sports in Florida throughout the entire state. So easy to sign up. fast deposits, fast withdrawals, PayPal, Venmo, credit cards, and more. What you got to do is download the app at the App Store, at the Google Play Store, or online at hardrock.bet. They make it very simple for the first-time bettor, and yet it operates perfectly for somebody like me that's been in this game for 25-plus years. NBA playoff push, NHL playoff push right now, perfect. Golf, you're watching a golf match and you're like, oh, I think he might come back on Sunday. Get in on it. It is a Hard Rock bet, and it is more fun than it should be as I make chicken wing money for myself on the regular. My streak did end, though. My streak did end. My streak came to an end. I said too much. Friday night, I caught a very bad break. Had a goal called back. A goal was scored.
Oh, wow.
And then they went back, and then the team challenged that the player was offsides.
That's frustrating.
Oh, you think? it went from a big win to a massive loss. But then Saturday went back to work, and with UFC 299 got business handled. Offered by the Seminole Tribe of Florida. Must be 21 plus and physically present in Florida to wager. Terms and conditions apply. Concerned about gambling, call 1-888-ADMITTED. Coming up in just a second, don't go anywhere. Legendary coach roasts a conference rival live on the air, knowing that they're doing this. You will hear who and what he said. It's the Home Team on ESPN 106.3.
Live from the Anajar and Levine Accident Attorney Studios. Anajar and Levine Accident Attorneys. Call 1-800-747-3. This is ESPN 106.3.
Are you tired like I am, falling asleep on the couch, groggy at work, losing focus on simple tasks? Ken LaVica here. Elite Anti-Aging Center can help. Low testosterone, hormonal imbalance. It's not just about your performance at the gym. It's the everyday grind life situations. And Elite Anti-Aging can help. Visit EliteTRT.com. Glenn and his team will give you that first virtual visit free. Don't wait until your next birthday. Do it now. Visit EliteTRT.com so you feel better about yourself.
If you've been injured in an accident that wasn't your fault, we have legal professionals standing by to answer your questions. They'll tell you if you have a case and how much it's potentially worth. Call 800-420-6060. So if you've been injured in an accident and think you deserve compensation, call now. Find out if you have a case and how much it's potentially worth. Call 800-420-6060 to speak with a live person now. Advertisement sponsored by Legal Help Center may not be available in all states.
At Lowe's, pros save big every day when you buy in bulk. Save 10% when you buy 230 or more select James Hardie fiber cement siding panels. And there's more. Save 10% when you buy 9 or more select premium foam flooring underlayment. Visit us in-store or online for low prices on the materials you need. Because Lowe's knows savings. Lowe's knows pros. Selection varies by location. While supplies last, discount taken at time of purchase. See sales associate for details.
Hey, it's Josh Cohen. When you are in need of any kind of auto repair, honesty and reliability are everything. Trust the home for honest, reliable service, St. Lucie Battery and Tire. Just like the name, St. Lucie Battery and Tire has all tire and battery brands in stock for cars, trucks, RV, marine, power sport, even golf carts. Major and minor service repairs, free tire pressure, and free battery checks. St. Lucie Battery and Tire, over 50 years in our community. 17 full-service locations, all the way from West Palm Beach to the Treasure Coast. Check them out at slbt.com. That's slbt.com.
It's the 4 o'clock hour on ESPN 106.3, fueled by Celsius, essential energy drinks. This is Josh Cohen and the Home Team, streaming live worldwide on YouTube on ESPN West Palm Play. Presented by Hard Rock Bet, Florida's official sports book. This is ESPN 106.3.
We are live in Stu Studio, almost like Phil Collins sang about Stu Studio on a Wednesday, the 13th of March. We are coming up Sunday on Selection Sunday, so be prepared for that because it's brackets to brokens by about Friday night dinner time for most of you fools. We'll see if we can help you a little bit. Legendary coach roasts a conference rival live on TV. You'll hear exactly what they said. And then the story gets worse, actually. The story gets worse, and there may be some guilt involved. Accidents happen. I was on the road today, and nearly was involved in one. Again, as a passenger in a rideshare. Yesterday, I was nearly involved in one. In a station vehicle. Ours. Anna Shaw and Levine accident attorneys are going to take care of everything. Because truck accidents and car accidents happen. Slip and fall, trip and fall. People get injured on the job. They have workers' comp issues. Mark Anishar and Glum Levine happen to be friends of mine. And they will fight for you to get you the maximum compensation that you deserve. They do not get paid unless you get paid. Consultation is absolutely free. Do yourself a favor. Call Anishar and Levine, accident attorneys. Let them help you to take back control of your life. Because you cannot deal with the insurance companies on your own. It takes one phone call. Take back control of your life. So do that. Begin the take back control. The number to call, it's easy to remember, 800-747-FREE. 800-747-FREE. 800-747-3733 for Anna Jar and Levine and their massive team of accident attorneys. Take back control of your life. CCAT last night, it was what, ACC tournament? Uh-huh. And it was Louisville, and NC State. And there was a three-point shot made, and then there was a gesture from the bench taking your fingers like you're making the owl thing, mm-hmm. you know, like you're making fake glasses, and then extending the threes out for the three-point made. There's a close-up shot of that happening, and then you'll hear the rest of the conversation.
Tell me, what is this celebration right here?
I don't know why anybody that's got the recent history of these guys is celebrating. Anything except, I guess, being here. I mean, that's it. That's all I can see.
Ernest Ross, signals.
Those are the three goggles, yeah. Coach.
I know what they are. But let's not celebrate until we win a game or two.
21 for Clark.
So, Coach, when someone on your team, you're coaching, yeah. and Carmelo Anthony makes a big three in the corner, and yeah. one of his teammates puts on the three yeah. goggles. Is it okay? Or
it's okay because we probably won 8 or 9 games.
Okay, that's fair. All right, that's fair.
It's celebration when you're down 20, like some of those guys do in football games or whatever. You know, celebrate that.
Okay.
Wait until you win.
It's a me culture is what it is. I wish we had time. I would share with you stories about Jim Boeheim. I spent a weekend with him in a rented house in the Hamptons 2 years ago for Memorial Day weekend. In fact, we'll carry that over to the second hour. We'll budget that, so we'll do it for next hour.
Sounds good.
Okay. How'd that game work out, CCAT?
Well, NC State did win that game. Mm-hmm. So after celebrating those threes, they won this early ACC tournament round.
Yeah.
And they beat Louisville, and because of how bad NC State is, apparently that loss to NC State,
yeah.
Louisville fired their head coach, Kenny Payne.
Not because of that loss. Louisville's win percentage over the last two seasons, or three seasons, I saw was like sub 200. It's like your batting average.
12 and 52, yeah.
Okay, so it was like your batting average
right around
in college
there.
Baseball.
It's not good.
Pretty close. Remind me on the Boeheim stories, because, man, that dude shared some things with me that I was like, wait, what? What the hell? And by the way, it involves our Miami Heat. And it involves our Miami Heat and one of our star players. I'll tell you what he said. I'm not talking out of class. Maybe he didn't know what I do for a living. It's too bad. Maybe you should know who your housemates are for the weekend. Coming up next, we got a boxing announcement. One of those circus fights. And this is a fight I think people actually want to see. Do they want to see it as a boxing match? We'll get into it next. It's the Home Team on ESPN 106.3.
Anishar and Levine accident attorneys, call 1-800-747-3. This is ESPN 106.3 WUUB Jupiter, a Good Karma Brands radio station.
Hey, it's Josh Cohen from the Home Team. Let's play a little game of question and answer. Who has the largest fleet of luxury vehicles in South Florida? A1A Limo. Who offers an on-time guarantee or your money back? A1A Limo. And whose drivers are background checked and average over 5 years of continuous service? A1A Limo. That's who. Whether it's for business or personal, from airport runs to nights on the town to games or concerts, A1A Limo is always the smart choice. Book now at A1ALimo.com. That's A1ALimo.com.
What you drive says a lot about you. And if what you're driving has the Ed Morse name on it, it says you expect a lot from your vehicle and even more from the people you bought it from. You see, at Ed Morse, we don't just sell vehicles, we stand behind them. And behind each and every one of the more than 2 million people who drive them. That's why we've been in business since 1946 and why every person who drives off our lot is backed by Morse.
Ed Morse proudly supports the Miami Dolphins. Make sure your next vehicle is backed by Morse. Visit edmorse.com today.
At Edwin Watts Golf Shops by Worldwide Golf, there's something that binds us all. The collective goal to transcend the ordinary. Introducing the all-new Vokey SM10 wedges. Made for lower flight, improved feel, and maximum spin. Unlock your ultimate wedge. Play with the new Vokey SM10 wedges. Visit us in store at Edwin Watts Golf Shops or online at worldwidegolf.com. Get there.
Every world-class team knows that when you choose better athletes, you move better as a team. That's why, each year, more than 500 professional athletes from every pro league and student athletes from more than 80 universities choose HSS for their orthopedic needs. Now, that same care is available in West Palm Beach and Wellington. Ranked number one in orthopedics worldwide, according to Newsweek, HSS is the A game of orthopedics. So if you want to move better, choose better. Visit hss.edu/Florida to book an in-person or virtual appointment today.
We all hear the radio ads about the IRS. They tell you to be afraid, to be scared, and they try to frighten you into calling. I'm not here to do that. Tax Relief Advocates is different. TRA is here to tell you that if you owe money to the IRS, whether it's $5,000, $50,000, or $500,000, we have a solution. It doesn't matter if you're sitting in your car, at work, or with your kids, no matter where you are, call now. 800-575-6759. Don't lose hope. TRA can eliminate or reduce what you owe to the IRS. There is zero risk to you. If we can't reduce your tax debt, then you pay nothing. Our passion is taxes and helping individuals fix their IRS problems. We have a 5-star rating on Google and Yelp and an A+ with the Better Business Bureau. You don't need to be afraid of the IRS any longer. End your tax nightmare today by visiting us online at TRA.com or call 800-575-6759. That's 800-575-6759. Tax Relief Advocates. Real solutions for real people.
We are proud of our parents.
Want to know why?
Because they work for the school district of Palm Beach County.
There's lots of great jobs.
With paid vacation, holidays off, health care, and retirement.
You can be in the same schedule as your kids.
Come work at the school district of Palm Beach County.
You'll see why it's your best choice.
Join us at the Team Palm Beach Schools Job Fair. Register at palmbeachschools.org/jobfair. That's palmbeachschools.org/jobfair.
I'm Ellie Anajar of Anajar & Levine. Injured in a car crash? Never rush to settle with insurance companies and never settle for just any attorney. Demand Anajar & Levine. Our experienced legal team will fight to win you the maximum compensation you deserve. Call me, Ellie Anajar, for a free consultation and take back control of your life. Call 1-800-747-FREE. That's 1-800-747-3733.
In office, West Palm Beach.
Hard Rock Bet presents Legal in Florida.
You can bet the game on Hard Rock Bet. No more betting inside your head.
Now Hard Rock Bet is legal in Florida. Now Hard Rock Bet is legal in Florida.
Legal in Florida.
It's safe, it's legal. We'll repeat that it is legal.
Top rated sportsbook, and it's the only one that's legal.
Get a no-regret first bet up to $100 when you sign up now. Offered by the Seminole Tribe of Florida. Must be 21 and over and physically present in Florida to wager. Terms and conditions apply. Concerned about gambling? Please call 1-888-ADMITTED.
Hey guys, it's Josh Cohen. When I want to watch the UFC, Twin Peaks is my local headquarters. With wall-to-wall 4K HD TV, you're there for every knockout. Never a cover charge to watch any of the fights. And once you step inside the lodge, you're surrounded by Twin Peaks girls, serving up made-from-scratch food and the signature 29-degree cold beer. Catch every main event at your UFC headquarters, Twin Peaks, located right off I-95 and Palm Beach Lakes Boulevard. Twin Peaks, eats, drinks, and scenic views.
ESPN 106.3. This is Josh Cohen and the Home Team, streaming live worldwide on YouTube on ESPN West Palm Play. Presented by Hard Rock Bet. Florida's official sports book. This is ESPN 106.3.
Look at that. Just like that, into the world-famous Home Team Cocktail Hour, a tradition for a quarter century almost. Damn it. Makes me feel old. Some things make you feel old. Doesn't matter how old you are. See, Cat, you're 25 and a half years old.
Uh-huh.
What makes you feel old?
I feel old when just seeing how much older my younger sister gets. The fact that she's 19 makes me feel old.
Got it. Jeanette, you are 37.
What?
No. 47.
No.
She's not 40 years old. Don't be a jerk.
Yeah, chill. I didn't say that.
33.
You're only you're only 33?
Yes. Stop.
I didn't know that. You just had a birthday celebration on the air not that long ago.
November.
Feels more recent than that. I think every day feels like your birthday.
Yeah, I mean, that's the way life should be lived.
That's exactly right, because every day is a life day.
Exactly.
And your birthday is the first day of life outside.
I am one of those people that celebrate their birthday for a full month.
You should. Don't you should celebrate it every day. Every day is a birthday.
Absolutely.
Anyway, you're 37, you were saying.
I'm 33.
30? That's all you are?
Yes. Let's not do this again. I'm 33, but I look younger. I look like I'm 25, let's be real.
Yeah, you don't look 33.
Thank you.
Yeah. Then again, I don't look 68. So
listen, a little cutie patootie, the one that I'm actually interested in where I bartend, he's 25, so let's see how this goes.
See how she loves these younger men?
Stop. And you know what's sad? I tried to like date in the older. It hasn't worked that well.
Why do you think she likes younger men? Because it's not physical appearances, necessarily. It's not just that.
I think it makes her feel younger.
I think they're just more fun, and I just need something fun right now.
I think you're exploiting these weak, feeble minds. Because they're not fully developed, and they're easy to manipulate.
Oh,
and you're able to play them.
Okay.
You know, he's trying to get into those 55-plus active communities, and he's got to be with you, and they won't let him in alone because he's too young.
She's 33 years old.
He's trying
jackass.
To take us. No, I know. That's so rude.
Call him a dumbass. Remember when he called you a dumbass?
No, but then we got in trouble for it?
Well, no, he got in trouble for calling you it.
So I'm not going to do the same thing.
You're not getting in trouble for calling him it.
Being it, apparently.
Can I say a dumb butt?
A what?
A dumb butt.
A dumb butt.
A dumb butt. A DB.
All right. There you go. There's your dumb butt. There you have it. Anyway, as I was saying, cocktail hours underneath. C-Cat, Dean Thomas isn't here today. He's handling business. What did Frank Sinatra say about the cocktail hour?
The cocktail hour. The numbers are sky high now that C-Cat has returned to the home team.
Which numbers are those?
Just all of them. The metrics.
People that want to smash their car into a bridge.
Stop.
It's the cocktail hour. For me, it is right now.
The cocktail hour is proudly presented by the Miami Open, where cocktailing will take place beginning on Sunday. Sunday is one day, meaning day one of the Miami Open. By the way, Miami Open, in case you didn't know, is where tennis comes to play. 15 days and nights of the best tennis in the world and the best tennis players. Defending champions are going to play. Daniil Medvedev, he comes back to defend. Petra Kvitova, she returns, as well as former champions Carlos Alcaraz, who's the best player in the world, Novak Djokovic. By the way, there's extra drama with him because he just got bounced early out there in the desert in Cali. So I imagine he's coming to get back on track with a little bit of fervor in his game. Stadium Court is in the center of Hard Rock Stadium. There's a tennis campus all around with other matches being played to advance in the tournament. Plus, food and restaurants like Kiki on the River, Bodega, American Social, and more. They come with pop-ups.
Love that. So much to do.
Also, beverages, signature cocktail stations, all new champagne garden.
That's what I want to hear. Say that again slowly.
The champagne garden.
All new. She was talking to me.
I was trying to give you a breather.
All new.
That doesn't sound.
Champagne garden.
I wanted to make it sound sultry and sexy, you like a champagne garden. Does sound
she
like?
She just said, "Say it slow."
Can you please make it sound sultry and sexy?
All new champagne.
C-Cat. Does this sound sultry and sexy?
Car crashes are going up more so now.
A desire to.
Yeah.
All new champagne garden.
That's sexy.
That's happening. Yep. That's happening. New restaurants this year, Milos, Fuku, and Henry's. There's also this year, for the first time ever, Major League Pickleball Tournament, Elite Wheelchair Tournament, Club Level, General Admission, Campus Passes, and Luxury. Seating options are still available, but they are limited. Go to MiamiOpen.com, MiamiOpen.com. Starts on Sunday, St. Patty's Day, goes through the 31st. That means 15 days and nights of tennis, the best tennis in the world. Miami Open is where tennis comes to play. And I'm going, just so you know. I'll be there.
You can find me at the Champagne Garden.
I bet we will. They'll be like, can someone please help us remove this woman from the Champagne Garden? And I'm like, oh, why are they not? And I go, oh, it's just Jeanette.
Let her stay.
Let her stay.
Yay!
We'll get the Champagne Garden chanting for you. If today's show sounds a little different, a little more organized, a little more streamlined, a little more efficient, CCAT planned it all.
Nice.
CCAT did this all himself. He chose the topics. He chose the questions. He chose the sound to be played. So if you're like, man, today's show's a little more streamlined, it's a little more just this to that, a little more concise, it's because CCAT is lazy. I mean, because CCAT's producing. And so far, so great. You feel good so far about your first show taking completely over? Because I think it's going pretty good.
I think it could have been better. I think there's
could
a
always
lot,
be
a
better.
Lot of, I think there's could a lot be of room to improve. I wish it had gone better so far. But we've got another half of the show to kick butt. Let's do it.
To kick that butt. Mm-hmm. You know how we go. Kick that butt.
Direct all of your complaints, concerns, and comments to @JoshOnAir on Twitter.
Do not do that, because Josh on Air on Twitter is suspended for telling the employees of Spirit Airlines, you guys should all join hands and jump into an active volcano.
That's legendary.
One, two, three.
Whee!
Do that. Do that.
You can send the complaints to me, though. Send the complaints.
Jake Paul, Mike Tyson announced for July 20th. And now another big fight announced for this summer. Nate Diaz, Jorge Masvidal. Two fighters that I've spoken with. One fighter who's been on this show, another that I've had press conference moments with. These two, in the fall of 2019, fought for the BMF belt. The baddest mother, shut your mouth, at Madison Square Garden. I was there for all of the action, including post-fight, when I had one of those moments with Nate Diaz. We're going to hear that coming up in just a second. This fight is slated for... What's the date on this, CCAT?
Got June 1st at the Kia Forum in Inglewood, California.
So the Kia Forum is basically the Forum. It's just the same building. Mm-hmm. It's where the Lakers used to play. The world famous Great Western Forum. So all those legendary Laker Western Conference championships and NBA championships in the 80s, that was at the... At the Forum.
I was going to be confused because me, as a diehard Orlando Magic fan, their arena is the Kia Center.
Got it. That's just a naming right thing.
Yeah,
but
I know.
The Forum is the Forum is the Forum. That's the Forum.
Yeah, but when you say Kia Forum, I was like, wait.
No, Inglewood. That's why he said Inglewood, California.
Yep.
Jorge Masvidal tweeted that he is unretired on New Year's Day. Masvidal on a 4-fight losing streak. His last win, actually, was that stoppage over a cut against Nate Diaz back the first weekend of November 2019. Madison Square Garden, UFC 244. I was there. You know, I remember most about that fight.
What?
I remember most about that fight card.
What?
They blocked off, closed the streets down because the president was going to be attending.
Oh, gosh.
For the first time ever.
Okay.
So it would look like a military zone.
Mm-hmm.
Meanwhile, it's New York City on a Saturday night.
Oh, gosh.
In the fall, it's also New York Marathon weekend.
Oh, so the worst of worst all circumstances.
It was impossible. Also, you know, I remember about that night, daylight savings time. I got pictures and video on my phone that show in the, because they didn't change the clock yet. Because in the fall, you fall back.
Mm-hmm.
But Masvidal comes to the podium and he's double fisting slices of pizza and his signature alcohol.
I remember.
And the clock says like 3:45 a.m. And you're like, what the? But it's because they didn't change the clock back to 2:45. But no matter what, we didn't get out of there until 3 a.m., whatever. Take a listen. I believe the sound you're going to hear, is this me?
It is you.
So this is after the baddest mother, shut your mouth, at Madison Square Garden, November of 2019. This fight, scheduled for five rounds. At the time, Dana White told everyone this is the most expensive belt we ever had made. Here's what I remember laughing about. Okay, a couple things.
Okay.
Ariel Helwani, who is MMA's, you know, like journalist, he's the guy. We are waiting to get inside Madison Square Garden. There's a media entrance, and they're not open the gates yet. They don't open the door yet for us to go. And so this was just 2 days after the Washington Nationals won the World Series. Remember who they beat?
They beat the Houston Astros.
They beat the doors off.
Howie Kendrick.
So we called that the Cacti Park World Series because both teams who are represented at Cacti Park.
Right.
So you can see them in the next 2 weeks.
And we've called it that for the last 2.5 weeks since it's been the Cacti Park.
You know that nobody lost or won. The Cacti Park won.
Yeah. Here's the thing. The Houston Astros were so bad
here
in that World
go.
Series.
Here we go.
They didn't win one home game. Not one home game.
Now
that entire
you're making
series.
This personal. Now you're really making this personal, aren't you?
I'm trying.
Weren't you talking about yourself?
That's true. You have a lot of great experiences in that home field of the Houston Astros, Jeanette. So show me any of them. How much you love that home
have
field.
Have you been to the home ballpark?
I haven't been to Minute Maid.
Yeah, you should go. You should go.
They've asked me a lot to go.
It was a lot more fun when there used to be a hill and a pole.
Yes.
That players used to run into and end their careers. That was a lot more fun.
Got Lance Berkman in center field for some reason, breaking his ankle. I love that.
Y'all are very dark.
There was a hill.
No,
you don't know this. When the Astros, were they still in the National League?
Yeah.
Yeah. When they were in the NL Central, this wasn't long ago, that ballpark had a hill in center field. A hill. And there was a flagpole, too, that you had to work around. Like, you know when you see football highlights from the 40s and the field and the goalposts are right there at the end zone?
Stop.
So you see dudes catch a ball and then bang into it?
Yeah.
That's what used to happen. I'm dead serious. At the Astros ballpark.
Yeah,
like, and Enron, it was Enron Field.
Mm-hmm.
Named after the disgraced company that was embezzling all the people in a pyramid scheme and robbed all those secretaries of their life savings.
Yankee Stadium or Polo Grounds had it in the past. They had Monument Park, like, looked like gravestones on the field of play.
Brooklyn Dodgers played.
I remember that.
Brooklyn Dodgers played at Ebbets Field. Who played at Polo Grounds? Nobody knows.
Highlanders.
I just can't imagine an actual flagpole being in the middle of a baseball field.
There was a pole in the middle of, but more than that, there was a hill that you had to run up to. And Hunter Pence used to run up that.
Yeah.
And make plays.
It's as if you had a sand trap, like a golf hazards on your baseball field, a hill.
No, it was like as if in the middle of the UFC octagon, there were tiny pits of quicksand that you could slip and fall into. Oh, he fell into the quicksand. Oh, no. There'll be no leg kicking, no action beneath the waist for the rest of this round. He's just going to have to sit here and throw strikes and defend himself.
Mario Banana, he can't step there, and all
yeah,
of a sudden
it's like
you're
Mario Kart, yeah. Right? The Astros had the only ballpark in Major League Baseball that had built-in Mario Kart obstacles. Mm-hmm. I'm surprised there weren't bananas and turtle shells and Mario.
Well, Houston Astros are a phenomenal organization.
Oil slicks, right? Oil slicks. Mario Kart, bing, bing, bing. Take a listen. This was me asking a question of Nate Diaz about. The fact that this fight is supposed to be the baddest. Oh, I forgot the rest of the story. So we're waiting to get in Madison Square Garden. It's cold out there. It's windy out there. And Ariel Helwani is Mr. Montreal, Canada. His team was the Expos. He's still sore about the Expos. He's not over the Expos being gone, becoming the Nationals. So he says, hey, dude, how you doing? And then I say, hey, congratulations. He said, on what? And I said, World Series title. Because the Nationals used
to
be the
Expos. Stop, you petty.
And he was like, yeah, no, that I don't recognize that team. He got mad. So then we go inside, and there's a whole presentation on the second floor of Madison Square Garden. And there's a step and repeat, and there's all this. And Dana comes out, and he says, we're about to unveil to you the most expensive belt that the UFC has ever commissioned to have made. And also, we're going to have photo ops with it. But if you would like a picture with the BMF belt, there are people that have boxes of white cotton gloves, and they're going to walk through and help yourself to them. And I was like, are you bleeping kidding me? Mark Raimondi, who liked me still at the time. He was standing there, and I looked at him, and he shook his head, and I said, I want to get this straight. We got to put white cotton gloves on, like we're the handlers of the Stanley Cup. Like, no, like we're a butler at Buckingham Palace to handle a belt that says on it, the baddest mother bleeper. And by the way, tomorrow night, it'll be covered with blood and saliva and other and snot and all kinds of other fluids.
But you clean guys who are just standing here like but decent you, gentlemen.
But because they wanted a whole pageantry
of it. Oh, for sure.
Right.
God help a smudge.
Yeah, got up. So they said...
nasties.
And so they're holding it and taking pictures, and they says, you want to hold it? And like it's a, somebody else's baby? I went, God, no. God, no. I don't need that. There, you know, reporters taking selfies, get my picture with the baddest mother. And the irony is not lost on me because Dana White did say, and Dana and I have our differences. We understand that. But Dana is a very smart man. And Dana said the toughest, meanest, hardest sport in the world is covered by the wimpiest, weakest people in the world. That's it. So you've got these MMA reporter, these journalist types. And some of them are, you know, have big followings and they're very successful and all that's great. But the bottom line is they're now wearing a belt that says baddest mother bleeper. And I wanted literally to cross it off and write weakest, wimpiest mother bleeper in the world. So the fight gets stopped because Nate Diaz has scar tissue and he's got a cut. But if you're having the baddest mother bleeper fight, it can't be stopped over a cut. You understand? It can't be won over a cut.
100%.
You got to knock somebody out. You've got to submit somebody.
Something better be broken.
They got to tap. Or they got to get knocked out. Or they have to be TKO'd to where the official says you can't defend yourself. Because baddest mother bleeper means that, like, yeah, you. It's not that, oh, there's a cut and the doctor said, I think we should stop now. Mm-hmm. But take a listen because this was my exchange with Nate Diaz, who lost the fight because of the cut, so therefore couldn't be the baddest mother bleeper. Listen.
What do you say to the irony that something called the baddest mother is decided by a cut?
That's what I'm saying.
There's irony in this. Elaborate, please.
And now he gets up and he starts walking off the stage.
Yeah.
To one of his coaches.
It doesn't make it official.
All right, you tighten that up. You cut some of it out.
It was a long clip.
Right. So what happened was I said, there's irony in this. He said, yeah. And I said, elaborate on that. And then he nodded, and then he turned to one of his coaches, and he said, what does irony mean? And then he stood up, and he walked over. He walked inside the stage, and I'm not trying to embarrass anybody. Irony is a pretty common word.
Yes.
And then Nate goes, uh-huh, yeah. So he sits back down and he takes the mic and he goes, as you were saying, and then everybody laughs because it's right now.
Yeah, because you could be using big words and punking this guy like, listen, funny guy.
Did we get any of his answer? You just cut that out. It's just gone.
It was really bad audio. He wasn't great. He mumbled a lot of different words out like I'm doing right now.
I heard the audio today. No, we got to hear his answer because he verifies what we're talking about. Mumbling. Do you know who Nate Diaz is?
Yes.
Okay. Are you aware of who he is?
That's his dialect.
Have you ever seen the show Family Guy?
Yeah.
Chris Griffin and Nate Diaz sound exactly the same.
Well, it's not only that. I feel like 50%
of them. Do
they
all...
not? Oh, yeah.
Chris Griffin. I don't know a Chris Griffin impression, but, you know, he sounds like Nate Diaz.
Plus 50% of all athletes mumble.
For sure.
And all audio.
Yeah, CCAP produced a show. See, this is one of those teaching moments right here where we'd say, ooh, we want to have this, a little more of that. But so far, so great, CCAP.
What he was saying, it's not official. The fight is, no, that's not official. I never quit. I never got knocked out.
That doesn't sound like Nate Diaz.
No, it doesn't sound like Nate Diaz at all.
You know what it sounds like? The guy who teaches your relatives English. That's what it sounds like.
Oh, no, not yours. It's not yours.
It's not your relatives. It's your girlfriend's relatives.
Yeah.
If you grew up in a Latino country, you definitely know about Ingles sin barreras.
So these guys are going to have a boxing match. It's going to be 10 rounds at 175 pounds in the light heavyweight division. It's a pay-per-view event. It is a company that was behind the Floyd Mayweather-Logan Paul event that not a lot of people seem to care about back in 2021. But with that said, is this a fight that you actually care about? Do you want to see these two box? Yes or no, Jeanette?
No, not really. If I'm at like Twin Peaks and I'm enjoying my beer and my billionaire
You'll
bacon,
watch it.
I'll watch it. But I'm not going out with the intention, what am I doing on a Saturday night? Let me go watch this fight.
You're not saying to yourself, hey, we got to make plans so we can watch
right.
exactly. a boxing match between these two.
Exactly.
See, Kat, are you interested in this fight?
See, I'm not 100% in yet, but I know by the time that weekend comes, on June 1st, I will be interested because of the two characters that are going head-to-head.
You notice it's happening before Tyson and Jake Paul.
Yeah.
Because they have to.
Of course.
You can't follow it.
You're not
yet.
Following.
No, right. You're not following that one.
You're not doing that. Jorge Masvidal and Jake Paul is a boxing match we'd like to see. Nate Diaz and Jake Paul is a boxing match that we did just see. I was there in Dallas this past August. I proposed it before. You got to go Diaz brothers versus Paul brothers.
Ooh, tag team?
Logan Paul, Nick Diaz, Jake Paul, Nate Diaz.
I'm down with that.
I proposed it once upon a time. I think in post-fight press conference, as a matter of fact.
How serious are you about that?
How serious am I?
I think the WWE, Logan Paul is already in WWE. I think that we are a lot closer to that than you might actually think.
I don't know about Nick Diaz fighting. Do you know anything about Nick Diaz fighting, let alone boxing?
WWE wrestling might put a show on him. Floyd Mayweather did some stuff with wrestling.
What do you know about Nick Diaz?
Nick Diaz is a tough guy. Tougher than his brother, some would say, because he kind of raised his brother.
I don't know. I don't know about that. Anyway, your segment's complete. Is there anything else behind that? Oh, should the UFC be worried? Should the UFC be worried about this trend? C-Cat wants to know. Which trend is that, bro?
Getting big in UFC, and instead of making your big fights, your big payoff fights, happen in the UFC, skipping town, going to a promotion where you get a higher cut of the money.
What do you know about Nate Diaz's contract with the UFC?
It is no longer...
It's expired.
It expired.
It doesn't
yes.
work there anymore. Okay. And so they didn't want to keep him, right?
Okay.
So since they didn't want to keep him, didn't need to keep him, weren't willing to, he can go do whatever. That's something they're willing to let happen. What about in the case of Jorge Masvidal? What's the status of his contract with the UFC?
That's where it's weird. He signed a contract 2 years ago, this time of year, 2022.
Okay. Right. How many fights?
The details didn't come out much at all about the details of the fight because then he retired after... one fight, Gilbert Burns. Mm-hmm. So the details are fuzzy on his exact contract.
Right. So they got to figure out if even this can happen without, if he's still under contract with the UFC for other fights. I think that he could get out for that. This doesn't feel to me to be a huge event because it's a boxing match. And because fans of these two and what they've done want to see these two dudes have elbows mm-hmm. to the face.
Yep.
Spinning hammer fists. They want to see violent actions with knees. Boxing match is great when you got the kid from YouTube Disney Channel who's now fighting somebody who used to be in MMA. But dudes in MMA fighting each other in boxing just feels like doing less than what it is we used to see you do, so who really cares?
I think that's a fair assessment. Or however, Jorge Masvidal, he actually talked about, he essentially did his first run with the media talking about this fight, talking about how much he now apparently hates Nate Diaz. And I think you'd be interested to hear what he's had to say.
Let's take a listen, because I can't imagine they're selling a fight or anything. Let's take a listen.
Because I want to murder this guy. And it's nothing personal with him, but I want to beat the brakes out of him. You know, he always said that the referee saved me. I don't think anybody with common sense would agree. So I think this fight right here puts an end to all that bullshit. I'm going to be in the best shape of my life. I know he's going to be in the best shape of my life. It's not like he's fighting Jake Paul and he's coming up off the couch. He knows that if he's not in shape, I'll make him look bad and I'll get him out of there in two rounds. He knows with me, you got to die every day in the gym to maybe step in that ring and have a fighting chance, you know, because I don't play that shit, man. I'm trying to kill this mother. And he knows it personally. I mean, he has the scars to prove it, you know. And he sees them things every day in the mirror when he looks and he goes, this guy's going to try to kill me, bro. So he can get in this for me. Get your ass in shape because I'm coming to break your face.
All right, that sounds to me like a guy who starts and realizes, all right, I got to do something with this, and then doesn't believe really what he's saying. And then later on works himself up to then start to get back to mm-hmm. selling a fight, because we've heard Jorge Masvidal when he means it, mm-hmm. and we heard it against Colby Covington, mm-hmm. and we've seen it, even Ben Askren. This is a case of a dude in Masvidal who, as he's saying it, is thinking to himself, am I sure I want to do this? And not because I'm afraid, Am I sure I really want to go this? He doesn't believe what he's saying at the beginning of that. And that didn't tell me anything about the fact that, ooh, I got to watch. And here's why. And here's what's on the line. It's literally two dudes who used to, in the UFC, be big stars. Obviously, the window for Masvidal was short, but it was sweet. He had a good run. He had a really good run. And it started with Askren's knee, and it continued with BMF. But this is still two dudes past their prime that are not going to be doing it in the UFC on that stage with that brand, with the spectacle that comes with that. And instead, you know the old expression about take the gloves off? These guys are putting the gloves on. You know, like, oh, that's what they're doing. There's nothing in there that tells me, oh, he hates Nate, and this fight's important. Let's do boxing ourselves.
Beep.
Okay, let's do boxing ourselves.
I'm a wrestling fan, so I get persuaded by the mic. I look for a reason to get excited for something.
Is that a good promo for you?
Yeah.
Yeah.
Of the stuff you see on wrestling television is guys behind a mic getting you excited about a match that's going to happen.
But here's the thing. We need heroes and we need villains. Okay? I had this conversation with Nate Diaz and Jake Paul last August at the press conference on behalf of Celsius, Essential Energy, Live Fit. And I said, gentlemen, I think I addressed it to Nate first. Every story, if you go on YouTube, I'm sure you can find it. Every story has a hero, needs a villain. You know, which are you? You need good guys and bad guys. Who's the good guy in Nate Diaz versus Jorge Masvidal? What's the narrative? What's the storyline? If they were boxers going to MMA, now I got a story. Because now that's a man who just bit a dog. But I got two MMA guys who are now going to fight each other in boxing, and it's not part of some global event. It's not some part of a Tyson Fury thing that's happening in Riyadh during season. It's two dudes at the old building where the Lakers used to play on June the 1st that are going to box for 10 rounds. Where's my good guy, bad guy? Where's my it's personal? Run back the BMF, but do this. Do an actual no holds barred. Do a fight where there's no rounds, or do a fight where you fight until somebody submitted or knocked out because there's no scorecards. That's the follow-up to BMF. Two dudes 5 years later boxing at the place where the Lakers used to play just feels like, hey, I'll be performing Tuesday night at the county fair at 5 p.m.
Absolutely.
And then after me is going to be the kids from the church. They're going
to
sing.
You know, the county fair, but pay your $5 tickets to go see it. It's just a big money grab. Good for them. Get your bag, but they know their names still pull a certain audience.
I don't know how much of a bag there is for this. Well, I don't know much.
More than what Nate Diaz has won outside of the UFC contract. It's probably his biggest payday in a hot minute.
Nate Diaz fighting someone that's not a former UFC fighter in boxing is the story. These two dudes, these former UFC fighters, boxing at this stage, each other, is not a story. This is just a dog that bit a man. It happens every day. Nobody cares. It's less of a story. It's less of an event. Regardless. Coming up when we return, Christian embarrassed himself, and it involves his girl, and it involves trying to do something for her. Mm-hmm. It involves trying to do something for his lady. You know what I'm saying?
Mm-hmm.
And instead, he completely embarrassed himself.
Yeah.
When
your anxiety tells you what's the worst or that can happen, it's going to happen. This is the worst that could have happened. Happened.
There you go. No anxiety for dinner plans tonight. It's real simple. It's Bud's Chicken and Seafood. Bud's Chicken and Seafood. Family owned, family operated. Since day one in 1957, the grandkids run each store. They're in the stores, in the kitchen, working behind the counter. This is great family value. This is better food made of better ingredients, prepared with family pride, that's passed on to you at the best value. This is not some major corporation, some international chain thing. It's one family with six locations, with Palm Beach County's best fried chicken as voted again. The greatest chicken tenders in life is decided by me. all the dipping sauces, crispy, crunchy, juicy, golden brown fried chicken tenders made of tenderloin that you dip in the sauce, take that first bite. The crunch tells your soul, we good. A little bit of steam escapes, like a cartoon ghost escaping to the heavens above. Don't worry, Seafood Fest, still happening, with fried crab cakes, fried oysters, butterflied coconut shrimp, corn fritters. All the sides are life-changing. They got the best crinkle cut fries. They got the best macaroni and cheese and coleslaw and macaroni salad and potato salad. All those salads, by the way, made in-house daily, fresh. Go to budschicken.com. I want you to try it if you've never had. And if it's been a minute, Bud's just makes a bad day better, and it makes a good day great. Budschicken.com. Order for pickup, order for delivery. Order ahead to have it ready for when you show up. Go to budschicken.com. Because it's Bud's Chicken and Seafood.
Yum, yum.
That was the best harmony yet. It was the best harmony we did. The music goes away. Coming up, we return. C-Cat embarrassed himself trying to make his girl happy. You'll understand what we mean next. Home Team, ESPN 106.3.
Live from the Anajar and Levine Accident Attorney Studios. Anajar and Levine Accident Attorneys. Call 1-800-747-3. This is ESPN 106.3.
For generations, hardworking people have relied on Ford F-Series trucks to help grow businesses, communities, families. A legacy of capability and technology that has made Ford F-Series America's best-selling trucks 47 years straight. This is the next generation of built Ford tough. Based on 1977 to 2023 calendar year total sales.
Time now for a PNC pause. PNC Bank is committed to helping the customers and the communities they serve move forward financially. See how they can make a difference for you at PNC.com.
Hey, it's Josh Cohen. Are you or a loved one experiencing memory loss, misplacing your keys, or forgetting people's names? Memory diseases affect not only the individual, but the entire family. Those over 50 should do memory screenings as part of their annual routine checkups. Brain Matters Research, with offices in Palm Beach County and the Treasure Coast, is offering complimentary memory screenings. Go to memoryscreeningsflorida.com. That's memoryscreeningsflorida.com. Brain Matters Research, making your memories matter.
All right, sports fans, let's get ready for some world-class soccer action. The MLS Showdown is happening, and it's happening right in your backyard at Chase Stadium in Fort Lauderdale. Come see him for yourself, the greatest of all time, the legendary goal scorer. Watch him create real magic, and after the game, indulge in a winning lineup of eats, drinks, and adventures in greater Fort Lauderdale. It's the perfect match. So make a fast break to visitlauderdale.com and check out some travel tips to score some goal-worthy fun in the vibrant heart of greater Fort Lauderdale.
We are connected internationally. We have relationships in the diamond industry that go back decades. Sources all over the world.
International Diamond Center's owner Keith LeClaire explains how IDC always offers to beat anyone else's price on a diamond.
We buy direct from the cutters, we pay cash, and we just don't believe in typical jewelry store markups.
With his background as a wholesaler, Keith says IDC's business model is based on lower margins and higher volume.
We're not here to sell you something for a quick buck.
So it comes down to better sourcing and low markups.
That's why we guarantee the best value price.
If you're buying a diamond, engagement ring, or any fashion jewelry, come experience a refreshing alternative to the typical jewelry experience at IDC.
We're here to offer the right price on every piece of jewelry that you buy from IDC.
Real value from real people.
We'd rather make a little bit and keep you as a customer than make a lot of it and lose you as a customer.
International Diamond Center, US 1 and PSL Boulevard, and online at shopidc.com.
The Palm Beach Health Network Physician Group, an affiliate of the Palm Beach Health Network, is committed to delivering high-quality care to the communities they serve. Their award-winning physicians and specialists provide a level of expertise that has resulted in regional firsts and outstanding patient outcomes. For a physician referral, call 866-654-2362. To learn more about the Palm Beach Health Network Physician Group, visit pbhnphysiciangroup.com. pbhnphysiciangroup.com to get in touch with the Palm Beach Health Network Physician Group. Group.
It's lights out in Miami. The 2024 Formula One Crypto.com Miami Grand Prix takes off May 3rd through the 5th. The three-day event is filled with art, music, world-class cuisine, and of course, top-notch racing. Tickets are available now. Choose from a variety of grandstands, each with a fantastic track view that puts you right in the center of the action and gives you access to the full campus. Visit F1MiamiGP.com. That's F1MiamiGP.com today.
ESPN 106.3.
Well, you can tell everybody. Yeah, you can tell everybody. Go ahead and tell everybody. I'm the man, I'm the man, I'm the man. Yes, I am, yes, I am, yes, I am.
This is Josh Cohen and the Home Team, streaming live worldwide on YouTube on ESPN West Palm Play. Presented by Hard Rock Bet, Florida's official sports book. This is ESPN 106.3.
Oh, we got a big one from the NFL. And a big signing. Big signing. This may surprise some people. This is... I didn't see this coming.
Mm-mm.
We'll tell you what this is coming up in just a second. First, though, Ed Morse Automotive Group. That's my friend Teddy Morse. And Carmine and the team. There's 2 million people that can admit and proudly proclaim that, yes, they've been backed by Morse. Because what you drive says a lot about you. And if what you drive has the Ed Morse name on it, it says a lot about the fact that you expect a lot from your vehicle and from the people that sold it to you. Ed Morse doesn't just sell vehicles, they stand behind them. And behind each and every one of the more than 2 million people who drive them. It's a family-owned and family-operated Ed Morse Automotive Group of dealerships been in business since 1948. 78 years of dedication to customers and community, supporting our military as well. So when Ed Morse says they have your back, believe it. Ed Morse proudly supports the Miami Dolphins and many other of your favorite South Florida institutions. Make sure your next vehicle is backed by Morse. There's nothing like knowing that when you buy a vehicle, that if you need, if something goes wrong, if it's just that the people that sold it to you, that they care and they make it right. EdMorse.com. EdMorse.com. Because you're always backed by Morse. This just in from the National Football League. Wide receiver Calvin Ridley is signing a four-year, $92 million contract. And that includes $50 million guaranteed with the Tennessee Titans.
Dang.
Dang is right. Now joins DeAndre Hopkins and Treylon Burks, the top pass catchers for second-year quarterback Will Levis. According to Teron Davenport of ESPN. Titans also agreed to a one-year deal with former Steeler quarterback Mason Rudolph. His deal's worth up to $3.62 million with incentives, obviously, and things that need to be met. So, Calvin Ridley to the Tennessee Titans. That means Will Levis has some aerial weapons.
Yeah.
He's got some targets. I thought Will Levis had moments last year, particularly against the Miami Dolphins on that, is that a Monday Night Football comeback?
Yeah.
Down 14 in the final 2 minutes and 55 seconds.
He's a gamer.
He is a gamer. He is a gamer. Anyway, Calvin Ridley off the board to the Tennessee Titans.
That's exciting for the Titans, too.
Of course it is. Of course
Heck
it is.
Yeah, good for them.
I'm kind of shocked that the Jags didn't find a way to keep him,
mm-hmm.
right? With building around Lawrence, of course. I feel like you want to keep your number one target.
And they seemed like they had some momentum last season, too.
Let's get to the topic that is story time on a Wednesday on a Home Team March 13th edition, which means we are 1 week and 1 day away from the sadness of March, from the gladness of March, from March Betness with Hard Rock Bet. Today, Christian Cat, producer, co-host of the Home Team Experience, you embarrassed yourself.
Yeah.
And you were trying to do something for your girl, and you were trying to, you know, make your girl happy.
Mm-hmm.
Today's story time is proudly presented by Truist. Start with care. Get a different bank at a better bank at Truist. See, Kat? Take it away.
So, there was a spontaneous trip to the bookstore yesterday. Mm-hmm. Just driving up the highway, saw it on those signs you see that indicate what's at what exit.
And now, for you, what constitutes driving up versus driving down a highway?
The compass direction.
No one ever says I was walking up the street.
Well done.
Right? I'm asking. Do you ever say I was driving down? Maybe if you're heading south, I was driving down the highway?
Mm-hmm.
Driving up the highway if you're going north?
Mm-hmm.
Okay. CK?
That's what I'm saying. I was going from the airport, Fort Lauderdale, all the way up to West Palm, mm-hmm. and I pulled off and said, you know what? Let's stop here. Why not? Treat. My girlfriend loves to read. She doesn't read as much as she would like to due to her work schedule. Said, let's get you a book.
How's your reading?
Read two books in my life.
Yeah.
I think one was Tim Tebow's book.
I can tell by the research you put into the topics you chose today that reading's not your favorite.
No. I'm not a big reader. Yeah. I wouldn't say so myself.
Right. Yeah.
But my girlfriend is. That's why we worked well together, right? What I lack in reading, she makes up for it.
That's good.
And I thought, you know what? We moved here about a year and a half ago. What's a good way to make friends but to share your interests? One of the hobbies she has is reading. Let's get her in a book club, right?
Get her in a book club.
Mm-hmm.
All right, find her a book club. Very nice. Except.
In case you haven't understood by listening right now, I've never been in a book club.
I was just going to say, I'm infuriated already.
So I don't really know what book clubs entail.
Why is Jeanette infuriated?
Book clubs are very small core groups, especially depending on the book. It's irrational to pick a book club.
So I didn't know that.
Yeah.
So I go up to the cashier and I say, so.
You thought it was signing up like Little League.
Yeah, I
100%.
Thought it's a men's recreational basketball league. Like, what time do you guys play? Yeah, 4 to 6.
Okay, so you went up to the woman at the customer service desk or behind the register?
Just behind the register.
Okay, even worse.
This
all right.
This is great.
Excuse me, nothing in hand. She knows I'm not paying for anything at the moment. Question for you. Do you have any information on the book club?
Oh, my gosh, Sika.
And she's like,
Jeanette's embarrassed
well,
for you.
Like, we have, like, the name of the company's book of the month, uh-huh. where we're encouraging you to read that book.
Right.
You have this thing, like, Oprah's book. Mm-hmm. And I'm like, no, something local.
You're like no,
somewhere
no.
you meet here
you
at the bookstore.
With other people.
Oh, my gosh. Now you're talking.
And she goes, well, that's kind of like a group of friends thing, where you meet up and it's intimate and you know each other. We don't really facilitate that. You kind of got to know somebody.
Were they laughing at you?
No.
Did you feel like on the inside they were laughing at you?
It wasn't laughing. It was worse than that. It was pity. It looked at me like I was lost.
Disgust.
Like I was no friends, out of place.
How are they wrong? How is that inaccurate? No friends, out of place. You're in a bookstore. You're you. How's it inaccurate?
Yeah, fair point. And I wanted to cut them off and say, got it. Okay, I understand now. As soon as she started talking. But no, she gave me another 30 to 45 seconds about the kind of dynamic of what a book club really entitles.
Mm-hmm.
And that was embarrassing. I was not only a loser, but I was a loser in the bookstore.
And then, yeah, which is hard to do. It's hard to do. Did you, and I love the bookstore. I love to go to the bookstore.
Yes, one of my favorite places to spend an afternoon.
I used to do a lot of like hungover Saturdays at Barnes & Noble.
Heck yes.
You just pop in, check the bargain where everything's all together, that
uh-huh.
three islands where, oh my God, I bought so much stuff from there.
I love bookstores.
Get a cookie. Did you explain? It's not for me, it's for my girlfriend.
I did. I led with that.
Oh, what a loser.
And she was like, I don't know, maybe 20 yards away from me. And I prefaced like, hey, I'm going to go ask. Like, and she said no, because she's going to feel stupid if she doesn't know the answer. She didn't know the answer, so we both felt stupid, and we ran out of there as soon as possible.
Maybe you guys can read books to each other.
Maybe.
Yeah.
We should. I don't know.
That's less embarrassing than what CCAT
you know what
just
that
experienced.
Is? You know what that is? That's a mom calling the mothers of other little boys that play together and say, hey, would it be okay if Dakota
uh-huh.
Played with, and they're like, they're 12 years old. They decide their own social groups. And she was, I know, but like and they're like, well, you didn't just move here. Like you've lived here. You know, they all go to school together. They've known each other since age one. Right. But could he join your friend group with your sons?
Yeah.
No.
That's how it felt.
Book clubs are actual conversations held regarding who you're sitting with and they decide where
didn't know.
You're reading.
Yeah. If you're watching on YouTube on our ESPN Plus channel, you'll notice that the sunglasses have gone on for me because we're in that window of the day in which the sunlight reflects directly off a window across the street and directly into my eyes, causing concussion-related migraines. So my sunglasses just went on right now.
Can I wear my sunglasses?
Absolutely.
I can't see the screens in front of me to do my job, so I got to take mine off. They're polarized.
You probably should. That was story time. And story time on the home team today was proudly presented by Truist. Start with care, get a different bank, get a better bank at Truist. Checking, savings, credit cards, mortgages, loans, investments. Truist says focus on life. There's things in life that matter. Your banking stuff shouldn't as much. We will take care of it. We'll hold it down. You go have kids. You go get married. You buy a home. You start a business. Whatever it is. Visit a branch. Check them out online. TRUIST.com. Because what people say doesn't matter, but what they do says everything. And the care shown in the community by Truist, well, that says all you need to know. TRUIST.com. Start with care. Get a different kind of bank. That's Truist. The two-minute warning is next, and it is not just the Twitter debate poll check-in, but we've got the Comedy Corner with C-Cat. This is just you solo?
Got three dynamite jokes.
All right, so it's the spotlight. Counting them down, 3, 2, 1. We'll do that next. It is the home team. This is ESPN 106.3.
At Edwin Watts Golf Shops by Worldwide Golf, there's something that binds us all. The collective goal to transcend the ordinary. Introducing the all-new Vokey SM10 wedges. Made for lower flight, improved feel, and maximum spin. Unlock your ultimate wedge. Play with the new Vokey SM10 wedges. Visit us in-store at Edwin Watts Golf Shops or online at worldwidegolf.com. Get there.
Whether it's a clutch touchdown pass, a game-winning dunk, or a dash to the finish, we want to highlight the best performance of the week presented by Baptist Health South Florida. Every week, different teams will be highlighted across ESPN 106.3 and ESPN West Palm Play. The winning performance receives $500 courtesy of Baptist Health South Florida. Know of a team, player, or school with a killer performance? Nominate them today by emailing highschool@espnwestpalm.com. Baptist Health Orthopedic Care. Go where the pros go.
What's the Anajar Levine difference? When you're injured in a car crash, we focus on your case so you can focus on the one thing that matters most, getting better. I'm Glenn Levine with Anajar Levine. We'll fight to get you the maximum compensation you deserve. Call our legal team right now for a free consultation. 1-800-747-FREE. We'll help you take back control of your life. Call 1-800-747-FREE. That's 1-800-747-3733.
In office, West Palm Beach.
Hey, it's Josh Cohen here to tell you about my favorite place to buy a vehicle. Go see my friends over at Ed Morse Automotive Group. They've got a huge selection of new and pre-owned vehicles. That's right, inventory is back. So you can shop, test drive Cadillacs, Toyotas, Hondas, Chevys, Buicks, GMCs, and quality pre-owned vehicles. Every vehicle is backed by Morse at 5 convenient locations throughout South Florida. Family-owned and operated since 1946. Let me tell you, this is the place you want to do business. See for yourself at edmorse.com. Remember, you're always backed by Morse.
ESPN 106.3. This is Josh Cohen and the home team, streaming live worldwide on YouTube on ESPN West Palm Play. Presented by Hard Rock Bet, Florida's official sports book. This is ESPN 106.3.
I know that Ryan Gosling absolutely destroyed it, singing I'm Just Ken at the Oscars.
And
I know that. And I know that they are making a musical version of The Notebook. The Notebook reminds us all why memory screenings are so important and why you want your parents and your loved ones to get one. And if you're 50 and over, that you need to get one. Should be part of your annual checkup anyway. Why? Because the end of that movie can be prevented. You see now, oftentimes, there's two FDA-approved treatments that are groundbreaking that stabilize progression, even restore some issues with Alzheimer's, a leading form of dementia. What I want you to do is go online to Brain Matters Research website for this study. It's Memory Screenings Florida. Memory Screenings Florida. Office in the Treasure Coast, office in the Palm Beaches. If you participate in the study, you'll be compensated for your time and your travel. There's nothing that they do that could cost you a cent. You don't need insurance, nothing. Just going to find out whether or not you're someone that might have issues with memory and memory disease. And if so, this might be something that allows you to keep your independence, your memories, and know exactly who you are for the rest of your life. Memory Screenings Florida, because Brain Meta's research makes your memories matter. It is the Championship of Cringe, Dad Joke Daily, just the best one you got. C-Cat, get rid of your number two and your number three, and let's hear your number one.
Why'd the roofer go to the doctor?
Why did the roofer go to the doctor? I don't know why.
He had shingles. That's a funny joke. You're no-selling it. Thank you, everyone at home, for laughing. We'll talk to you tomorrow.
It's a little too... I think it's too...
I think everybody blatant. Definitely...
Coming up next, it is the boardroom. Should be spelled B-O-R-E-D. Never gets old. Thank you, Ken Levicka. We got Heat and Nuggets, 7:10 p.m. with the pregame. I'm sorry, 7 p.m. with pregame. Kids, tip at 7:30. Every day above ground.
It's a good day.
Say goodnight to the bad guy.
Bye-bye, bad guy.
Have a great night. Back at 4 tomorrow, home team time, 6 p.m.
Manager and Levine Accident Attorneys, call 1-800-747-FREE. This is ESPN 106.3 WUUB Jupiter.